नमस्ते। सो नाउ लेट्स कवर आउट अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट यू नो द क्वेश्चन दैट यूजली पॉप्स अप इज दैट कमेंट ऑन द टॉर्टियस लायबिलिटी ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट, ट्रेस आउट द हिस्ट्री ऑफ द लॉ ऑन टॉर्टियस लायबिलिटी ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट, एलुसिडेट ऑन द डॉक्ट्रिन ऑफ सॉवरन इम्यूनिटी एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा। तो आपको क्या आंसर लिख कर आना है एंड यू व्हाट ऑल केस लॉज डू यू हैव टू मेंशन अंडर दिस टॉपिक। ऑलराइट, सो एन इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन विच अकर्स फ्रीक्वेंटली इज द टॉर्टियस लायबिलिटी ऑफ गवर्नमेंट of its servants. So as soon as you begin the answer, mention article 300 and suits and proceedings. Yahi likhiyega. Do mention the title of the article, all right? Because that will tell the examiner that you know a lot. The government of India may sue or be sued by the name of the Union of India, and the state government obviously will be sued by the name of the state. If at the commencement of this constitution any legal proceedings are pending to which the Dominion of India is a party, the Union of India shall be deemed to be substituted for the Dominion in those parties. So what does that mean? That the Union of India is pari passu with liability of East India Company. Wahi hua na, we carried over the liability. Jaise East India Company was liable, now the Union of India is liable after the commencement of the constitution. If you wish to mention this point, do. If you do not wish to, you can skip this point, but have to mention Article 300, have to mention suits and proceedings, have to start out with your answer with a language such as this, because you know otherwise then it really doesn't make any sense to straight away jump into Article 300. Now as soon as you have written Article 300, go and write mention P&O Steam Navigation Company was Secretary of State, because this is pretty much the first cardinal case law that is associated with this topic. Alright, so the P&O company made a claim for damages for injury caused to its horse by some government worksman. The Bombay High Court held that where an act was done in exercise of sovereign powers, no action would lie. So as soon as, you know, the government is, let us say, doing anything under its own sovereign powers, you'll have to ignore the background noise a bit. I think they are wo machhro wali dawai dal rahe, I think somewhere in the colony, so that noise is there. Alright, so the Bombay High Court held where an act was done in service of the sovereign power, so no action would lie. Sarkar agar apna kaam kar rahi hai, agar Hindi mein baat karo tumhe, to phir there is no tortious liability of the state with respect to its servants. So two principles emerged from the P&O case. Alright, now this is not the law. This is the, we are tracing the history of the law. So two principles emerged, that is, aapka, just like, you know, East India Company ke upar case aaye, the Secretary of State will be liable. Suit can be brought. This is a very old case, so that's why they are saying Secretary of State. Tab us zamane mein hota tha Secretary of State. And Secretary of State is not liable for anything done in the exercise of sovereign power. Write the second point down, kyunki isi ko aapko elaborate karke apne answer mein aana. Theek hai ji? So the second point has been departed from you over the course of years. So many cases followed. Many cases did not follow after the P&O case, but usually every case refers back to the P&O case. Hamesha baat aap yaad rakhenge, theek hai ji? And ye aapka wo prelims type ya MCQ type bhi question, P&O case, which is the cardinal case law, which is the primary case law on ye sovereign immunity, that's the P&O case. Aur uske baad abhi dobara aa rahe hain jo recent jo time ke jo cardinal case laws hai uspe. Now the Union of India versus Harbhajan Singh in 1959, in which a military truck driver was on military duty and then I think it caused an accident. It was held that he was on basically sovereign function and was not held liable. So for example, presume this, that you're going up Manali via Leh Ladakh ja rahe, then there's a military truck who's just driving, you know, madly and just transporting, let us say, some missiles, some arms, some ammunition. Will the state be held liable? The court said sorry. So they are following the P&O case, because जो मिलिट्री वाला जो वो जो काम जो वहाँ पे जो चल रहा है, इट इज़ एन एक्सरसाइज ऑफ द सॉवरन पावर. तो नाउ दिस इज अ वेरी वेरी ग्रे एरिया ऑफ लॉ. व्हाट इज सॉवरन एंड व्हाट इज नॉन सॉवरन डिपेंड्स ऑन जज एंड कोर्ट टू कोर्ट एंड केस टू केस. ऑलराइट, सो वी दिस इज व्हाट यू हैव टू डेमोंस्ट्रेट टू द एग्जामिनर दैट यू नो दिस फैक्ट. बिकॉज इफ यू नो दिस फैक्ट एंड इफ यू कैन डेमोंस्ट्रेट दैट टू द एग्जामिनर दैट यू नो इन दिस मैनर, नंबर कैसे नहीं आएंगे, कैसे नहीं आएंगे नंबर. ठीक है जी? सो देन एक तो एक केस लॉ आप अपने आंसर में ये मेंशन करेंगे, फिर दूसरा केस लॉ आप मेंशन करेंगे सेक्रेटरी ऑफ स्टेट वर्सेस हरी भांजी या भंजी भांजी नहीं भांजी होगा BHANJI. सो सेक्रेटरी ऑफ स्टेट वर्सेस हरी भांजी. सो यू नाउ इन दिस केस यू आर बेसिकली डूइंग उल्टा, दैट वी आर नॉट फॉलोइंग दैट सॉवरन पावर वाली थ्योरी दैट वॉज गिवन इन P&O. अब इसके अंदर आप केस लॉ के अंदर ज़्यादा कोई डिटेल नहीं मार्क करेंगे, बिकॉज दीज यू नो द आंसर विल कीप ऑन गेटिंग एलोंगेटेड. हमने दैट्स नॉट अ पॉइंट, जस्ट टेल द एग्जामिनर दैट the following the proposition or the proposal of pointer number 2 in the PNO case, cases following proposal number 1, basically yahan pe aap confuse nahi hoenge, to I'll just give this to you. Basically ye jo cheez hai ki hum is cheez ko follow kar rahe hain as the law propounded in PNO case. So they are saying, you know, we are following it. So the number of cases following it far outnumbered the number of cases not following it. Theek hai ji. The state of Rajasthan versus Vidyavati, this is the most important case law from modern times. So this is 1962. Usually jo MCQ wagera aate hain either PNO wale case pe aate hain ya ye state of Rajasthan versus Vidyavati pe aate hain. Theek hai ji. But if you're obviously when you're writing an answer, to yahi to answer, matlab agar aap, let us say you're writing for the law optional, well, great, this is how you frame out the answer. All right. So driver of a jeep is basically aapko ye collector jo saab hain. So driver of a jeep belonged to collector. Collector was driving it back rashly and negligently while bringing back from workshop. They fatally injured a pedestrian. So PNO case, well, was referred to. The view was broadened. The state liability was broadened. So presume, just you can just think about it. Let us say SDM saab ka, which you will be, since you'll be writing the law optional very very soon, and hopefully, you know, clearing it, acing it with marks. Let us say that your jeep, the driver of your jeep goes to the workshop to collect, ek aapne apni jeep service ke liye due to collect it back, theek hai ji. So you are driving it back rashly and negligently while, you know, you, the driver is coming back and he fatally injures a pedestrian. Now think about it. Think, should the state government be held liable, right? So this is the question that came up. So PNO case was referred, the view broadened. So the Supreme Court didn't overturn the PNO case. It just said that if it's done in the course of employment but not in the exercise of the sovereign power, the state will be held liable. Now what do you mean by, you know, done in the course of employment? So ab iske andar koi sarkari kaam ho raha hai kya? If the jeep is being coming back from the workshop, is there really any sovereign power here being involved that you cannot do this work without getting the sovereign involved? Think, नहीं होगा ना ऐसा, right? तो जब नहीं हो रहा, जब इसके अंदर sovereign involved भी नहीं हो रही, मतलब this is basically an act that can be done by a private person as well, just getting the jeep back. Therefore, you will be held liable. But let us say कि इस jeep में some official secret documents were being transported back from the parliament to the SDM office, ऐसी कोई hypothetical condition. देन तो सॉवरन की पावर हो रही है ना एक्सरसाइज. अब तो टोटली प्योरली सरकारी काम है जो कि सरकारी तरीके से ही होगा, वहां पे स्टेट विल नॉट बी हेल्ड लायबल. स्टेट ऑफ राजस्थान वर्सेस विद्यावती में वो कह रहे ड्राइवर तो प्राइवेट पर्सन भी तो दे सकता था ना वापस. लेट प्रिज्यूम दिस दैट वर्कशॉप से दैट देर वॉज एन एम्प्लॉई हु जस्ट ड्रोव द जीप बैक एंड फेटली इंजर्ड. कुड दैट टास्क बिन बेसिकली द टास्क ऑफ ब्रिंगिंग जीप बैक टू द SDM ऑफिस कुड दैट बी डन बाय अ प्राइवेट पर्सन? यस, राइट. सो देयरफॉर इट्स नॉट प्योरली अ सॉवरेन पावर. अब मुसीबत क्या है कि कोर्ट्स आर वेरी अनक्लियर. सो दिस इज वॉट यू विल राइट एंड यू विल राइट एज अ क्रिटिसिज्म कि जी जुडिशियल अप्रोच इज वेरी अनक्लियर. सो सुप्रीम कोर्ट टुक अ यू टर्न इन कस्तूरीलाल रायला राम जैन वर्सेस स्टेट ऑफ यूपी एंड यहाँ पे आपने थ्योरी ऑफ सॉवरन पावर वॉज प्रोपाउंडेड इन दिस केस लो. सो पुलिस सीज गोल्ड फ्रॉम रायला राम, द कॉन्स्टेबल मिस अप्रोप्रिएटेड द गोल्ड. The state was held not to be liable, but the Supreme Court said in this case. अब इसके अंदर क्या है? पुलिस वाले आए, पुलिस वालों ने they confiscated gold and one of the constables is misappropriated. That means pretty much, you know, आप कह सकते हैं sold it off for his own personal gain, right? Supreme Court said the हम decision तो दे रहे हैं, but the situation is not acceptable. The law is unjust to people. Sovereign versus no sovereign की distinction is very difficult. किसी भी टाइम, अब यहाँ पे इसको हमने सॉवरन कर तो दिया बिकॉज पुलिस का काम था, तो ऑब्वियसली इट्स प्योरली अ सॉवरन एक्सरसाइज, बट इट्स सर्टनली नॉट जस्टिस, राइट. दैट्स व्हाई दिस केस लॉ इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू मेंशन इन योर आंसर. नाउ द फर्स्ट रिपोर्ट रेकमेंडेड, द लॉ कमीशन फर्स्ट रिपोर्ट रेकमेंडेड टू इनएक्ट अ लॉ, बट नथिंग टिल डेट. वेल, गवर्नमेंट अपने आप को फंसाएगी थोड़े ना यार, राइट. सो जनरली नाउ यू विल क्लोज ऑफ योर आंसर विद दिस. That a sovereign function is one which can only be performed by state and not private individuals. All right. And running of, like, you will now not mention case laws. कोई case laws आपने बतेरे लिख दिए. ये छोटे-छोटे case laws आपने, there is absolutely no need to mention them. Like running of bus service by state, no need for these judgments here. Running of bus service by state has been classified as a non-sovereign function, so the state will be held liable. activities of public work departments of state, non-sovereign functions. Why? Because they can be done by independent contractors as well. So that is the test. Use of military vehicles to carry teams, etc. So presume that Air Force ki bus la rahi hai aapki koi basketball team from the airport back, and then it gets into an accident, the state will be held liable. Hospitals, so the earlier judgment was that they are part of the sovereign function because sarkari hospitals basically. Now, thanks to Achyut Rao, Hari Bhau, Khodwa versus State of Maharashtra, aap yaad kar sakte hain, theek hai, nahin yaad kar sakte, it's absolutely fine. Just mention ki now, thanks to the Supreme Court's recent, so anytime that you've forgotten the name of a judgment, no need to worry, just craft out your language very smartly. Just say, as per the recent judgment of the Supreme Court, avoid mentioning the judgment because you've forgotten about it. The current position of law is, wo to yaad rahega na, that the state will be held liable for its employees in sarkari hospitals. So employees in sarkari hospitals, the state is liable. Doctrine of sovereign immunity was criticized. In here, this is a very recent case law, Nagendra Rao versus State of Andhra Pradesh. So there was this guy who was stocking fertilizers for food grains, etc. And the shop owners, basically, he was a shop owner, and the authorities seized it. So the police, you know, charged him with some offense. No need to get into specific details. They seized the saman, and he kept informing the authorities ki, please sell the fertilizer, otherwise it will expire. So the trial happened. He was acquitted. He was completely free. So he was found not guilty, and the stock was returned to him, but it was expired. So he filed a claim against the government. The Supreme Court held state to be liable. And in this case law, they basically criticized the doctrine of sovereign immunity. Yaad hai, humne international law mein bhi iske bare mein baat kari thi. Theek hai ji? Acha. So what are your remedies? Now it's time to close up the answer. What are your remedies? Civil suit, right? And basically, aapke writs mein, writs ke dwara apni, the principle of compensatory jurisprudence was propounded in Rudal Saha versus State of Bihar. And here civil suit lagayenge. और यहाँ पे कॉम्पेंसेटरी जूरिसप्रूडेंस के तहत ये जो जो बेसिकली जो फंडा वो दिया गया था रुदल सावर स्टेट ऑफ बिहार में कि अगर आपके फंडामेंटल राइट्स वायलेट हो रहे हैं तो आप कृपया करके क्या बोलते हैं आप सुप्रीम कोर्ट चले जाइए एंड फॉर योर फंडामेंटल राइट बीइंग वायलेटेड सुप्रीम कोर्ट विल पे यू मनी. तो यूजली दिस इज द न्यू ट्रेंड कि आप रिट के द्वारा भी पैसे निकलवा सकते हैं स्टेट से. ठीक है जी. सो दिस फिनिशेज ऑफ एंड डू मैंशन कि देर इज नो स्पेसिफिक डिस्पाइट द सुप्रीम कोर्ट एंड लॉ कमीशन suggesting time and again for the government to enact a law clarifying what is sovereign, non-sovereign, etc. they haven't really done so because you know that's an escape route for them. Kaun paise dena chahta hai na zyada, right? To sarkar bhi wahi hai. So this is an important question that pops up often in the law optional. To kripa karke aapka ye answer ab taiyar hai. Isi question ke 5 alag alag prakar aaye, but liability of state, tortious liability, falana dhamka, सब कुछ के लिए एक ही सेट आंसर, अपने आंसर तैयार कर लीजिए. मेरे हिसाब से दिस ऑप्शन विल बी एब्सोल्युटली नो प्रॉब्लम. ठीक है जी, आगे चलते हैं. लेट्स कीप ऑन प्रिपेयरिंग आवर आंसर्स. ठीक है जी, टेक केयर, बाय.